The outstanding debt of the Philippine government soars to a new record high in October. The country's total debt stock reached 11.97 trillion pesos. That's higher than the 11.92 trillion pesos logged in September. The Treasury Bureau mainly attributes the increase to the issuance of domestic securities. The Philippine government has been borrowing heavily to boost its COVID-19 war chest.
The Philippine Senate approves on final reading the government's 5 trillion peso national budget for 2022. 22 senators voted to pass the measure, which aims to support the country's pandemic recovery. The proposed budget bill will next go through a hearing of the bicameral conference committee. Lawmakers are looking to finalize the bill in the second or third week of December before it's sent to President Duterte for his approval.
The Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development warns the Omicron variant is threatening the global economic recovery. The group slashed its 2021 growth forecast to 5.6%, down from its earlier estimate of 5.7% amid new developments on the COVID-19 front. But it retained its 4.5% forecast for 2022. The OECD now appeals for a swifter vaccination rollout, saying areas with low vaccination rates could create breeding grounds for deadlier virus mutations.
The global recovery continues to progress. GDP in most countries is now close to the pre-pandemic path. Massive fiscal and monetary policy support to households and firms from the outset of the crisis, the relatively rapid development of vaccines, the accelerating digital transformation in the wake of the pandemic have all helped get us into this position. But the growth momentum is slowing and disparities in the recovery remain. We must continue to be vigilant in responding to any new infection outbreaks which can undermine the recovery both globally and regionally.
Aside from vaccine inequity, the OECD says inflation also remains a great risk to the global economic recovery from the pandemic. It also raised concerns about the rising trend in COVID-19 debt and governments around the world.
The G20 countries have spent $10 trillion supporting people and their economies since the beginning of the pandemic. It would only take $50 billion to ensure vaccination worldwide. The COVID crisis has increased debt levels, and as I've mentioned before, this was appropriate in the crisis. So the COVID debt is not the concern in itself, but rather the rising trend in debt over decades. And as the recovery progresses, the issue now is what are governments doing with this money?
The Omicron variant on top of mind during the annual forum of joint foreign business chambers here in the Philippines. As Juan Guzman tells us, while stakeholders have different takes on how it will affect recovery, they all agree the Philippines is in need of more foreign direct investments to help the economy bounce back.
The joint foreign chambers opened their annual Arangkada Forum Wednesday, a venue which they use to hold discussions on what courses of actions they might recommend to the Philippine government to improve the economy. Right from the get-go, they expressed concern about the new Omicron COVID-19 variant, especially with the difficult circumstances created by the nearly two-year-old pandemic.
While the Philippines is not the only Asian country in this situation, its lockdown was longer than most. Should we see effective national leadership, good economic management, continuity of sound policies from one administration to the next, we expect recovery and growth will come. But recovery alone is just the old normal. We think there must be a better normal to attract substantial foreign investment and trade to really boost the economy. As you will hear it said repeatedly, this country has amazing potential, amazing people, amazing possibilities, but for a long time it has fallen short of realizing them.
International management consultant McKinsey and Company says Omicron and other new variants could push the Philippine economic recovery back to pre-COVID levels as far back as 2023.
We could go back from a GDP perspective to pre-COVID levels by the third quarter of next year. And if the virus and the new variants then take more longer hold, that could extend to probably the first quarter of 2023.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno and Representative Joy Salceda, Chairman of the House of Representatives Committee on Ways and Means, say there is reason to be optimistic.
People have been very negative about our very high mobility restrictions, but it seems now we've been able to reduce it. And at the same time, care of our DOF and our NTF, we've been able to accumulate already 150 million in vaccines.
The sustained implementation of targeted fiscal initiatives, as well as the acceleration of the vaccination program, should help boost market confidence and consequently economic recovery.
Salceda and Jokno have also been proponents of opening up the Philippine economy to more foreign direct investments. And Salceda says progress is being made in legislation, including the amendment to the Public Services Act, which should allow more foreign dollars to flow into the all-important telecommunications sector. That sector has been plagued with complaints of poor service amid a massive pandemic-fueled spike in data usage. Meanwhile, one of the framers of the 1986 Constitution, alongside another well-respected economist, said more foreign direct investment in Philippine creative industries could help Filipino artists ascend to the heights of Korean pop sensation BTS.
It's been the way the Korean government has been so focused. You know, they organize talent camps, they train thousands of people, etc., so that they're able to compete in the global market.
I think, though, that we can't realize the potential, really, of the creative industries unless we remove the foreign ownership restrictions in mass media and advertising. Or else, what will happen? As you, ABS-CBN got shut down, supposedly for violating, the 100% foreign ownership rules in the, you know, ADR, and also Gabby Lopez being an American citizen. And Bernie mentioned BTS. BTS is foreign capital behind their management company. You know, they accept foreign capital.
The Joint Foreign Chambers will be presenting its recommendations to the new administration after the elections in 2022. With the polls fast approaching, it will be hard for Congress to get any work done on these reforms. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
The Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development warns the Omicron variant is threatening the global economic recovery. The group slashed its 2021 growth forecast to 5.6%, down from its earlier estimate of 5.7% amid new developments on the COVID-19 front. But it retained its 4.5% forecast for 2022. The OECD now appeals for a swifter vaccination rollout, saying areas with low vaccination rates could create breeding grounds for deadlier virus mutations.
The global recovery continues to progress. GDP in most countries is now close to the pre-pandemic path. Massive fiscal and monetary policy support to households and firms from the outset of the crisis, the relatively rapid development of vaccines, the accelerating digital transformation in the wake of the pandemic have all helped get us into this position. But the growth momentum is slowing and disparities in the recovery remain. We must continue to be vigilant in responding to any new infection outbreaks which can undermine the recovery both globally and regionally.
Aside from vaccine inequity, the OECD says inflation also remains a great risk to the global economic recovery from the pandemic. It also raises concerns about the rising trend in COVID-19 debt and governments around the world.
The G20 countries have spent $10 trillion supporting people and their economies since the beginning of the pandemic. It would only take $50 billion to ensure vaccination worldwide. The COVID crisis has increased debt levels, and as I've mentioned before, this was appropriate in the crisis. So the COVID debt is not the concern in itself, but rather the rising trend in debt over decades. And as the recovery progresses, the issue now is what are governments doing with this money?